It's been more than 50 years since the last crewed mission to the moon. We've had to wait a long time to see NASA's monster Space Launch System arrive at Launch Pad 39B at the agency's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The SLS is as famous for its height as its delays. NASA promised to launch the mega rocket as early as 2017, only to postpone it again and again. Its maiden voyage without a crew aboard is now scheduled for this summer. Although the SLS is setting the stage for America's return to the moon, possibly by 2025, it's unlikely to be used for long. This may, in fact, be the beginning of the end for the SLS.
That's because the SLS is very, very expensive to fly.
NASA's independent watchdog revealed the cost of launching the SLS in Orion spacecraft just once is $4.1 billion. Inspector General Paul Martin called it unsustainable. That figure, by the way, is 8 times higher than NASA's original estimate of $500 million per launch. One of the reasons the cost is so high is that the monster rocket is not reusable. After the SLS lifts off and burns through the fuel in the boosters and core stage, it drops them, kind of like how a hiker drops a heavy backpack to climb the last few miles to the top of the mountain.
So why has NASA spent so much money developing a rocket that can only be used once?
Former Senator Bill Nelson, who now runs NASA as administrator, explains that the program is an economic engine for America. In 2019 alone, it supported 70,000 good-paying jobs across the country. Spending huge amounts of money is reminiscent of the space agency's operations in the 60s and 70s, when NASA flew 24 astronauts to the moon as part of the Apollo program. Yet the goal at that time was different than it is now. Back then, going to the moon was a political statement showing off America's technological might during the Cold War standoff with the Soviet Union. Today, landing on the moon is but the first step of a bigger plan. In 2004, President Bush directed NASA to return to the moon with a goal of living and working there for increasingly extended periods of time. The aim is establishing a presence on the moon and eventually on Mars. Whether NASA will help us get there is uncertain. Former NASA Administrator Charles Bolden predicted in a 2020 interview with Politico that the SLS will go away. It could go away during a Biden administration or a next Trump administration, because at some point, commercial entities are going to catch up. It seems they already have. SpaceX is developing its giant Starship to take people to the moon and Mars.
Let's make this real.
Let's make this real!
Starship stands taller than any of the planned SLS models, beginning with the initial configuration, Block 1 cargo, ending with the Block 2 cargo. It also touts the ability to send more tons to low Earth orbit. Besides the specs, what really sets the launch vehicles apart is their price tag. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has said Starship could eventually fly for just $2 million per mission, as opposed to the SLS's $4 billion. Even if it costs more than $2 million, it will still be far less than the SLS, because Starship is reusable. Both the first stage booster, the Super Heavy, and the upper stage spacecraft, Starship, can return to Earth and fly again. NASA was so impressed with SpaceX that it has chosen Starship to help with the final leg of the journey to the moon. A modified version of Starship will help land the first woman and next man on the lunar surface. The journey would begin on Earth with the SLS, which lifts the Orion spacecraft carrying astronauts on a path to the moon, helping it escape Earth's gravity. Then, Orion would meet up with a modified lunar variant of Starship in lunar orbit. The crew would transfer to Starship, which would then take them to the surface of the moon. For the trip home, Starship lifts off, meets up with Orion, which was left in lunar orbit. The crew transfers over to Orion and returns to Earth. But what if Starship was used to go all the way to the moon without the need for the SLS or Orion? Starship could launch, meet up with another Starship to refuel before journeying to the moon. This version of Starship is not the lunar model. It still has the heat shield and flaps for landing back on Earth. SpaceX isn't the only commercial company with big plans for space. Blue Origin is getting another shot at securing a NASA moon landing contract after initially losing out to SpaceX. Jeff Bezos' space venture is also reportedly trying to make its heavy lift launch vehicle, New Glenn, fully reusable, like Starship. So NASA does appear to have private options to lean on. In many ways, the SLS is a final hurrah for NASA, paying homage to the days of the past. It uses the main engines from the space shuttle. Its twin solid rocket boosters are built on a foundation of knowledge and experience gained from developing the space shuttle boosters. Once SpaceX and others test and fly their reusable rockets successfully, the game will change forever, opening up an era of space travel where trips to space could be as frequent as planes fly. If you're passionate about space and want to learn more, My friends at CuriosityStream have a wealth of incredible documentaries on traveling beyond our planet that will enlighten and inspire you, like this one about the historic Apollo moon landing. There's also a series called Space Greed that I happen to make a guest appearance in.
Astronauts have conducted about 3,000 experiments on the International Space Station.
You can check out the full episode on CuriosityStream's YouTube channel, which I'll link in my description. And if you'd like to watch thousands of captivating and educational documentaries on CuriosityStream, it's only $14.99 to sign up for a full year, not month, but year. Just head to curiositystream.com/newsthink, which I'll also link in my description and pinned comment. Thanks for watching. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.